Good morning, students. Today, after vacations, we will continue with the writer. Before vacations, we discussed something about writer, but now we will discuss this in detail. We know that when we use any type of word processor, like MS Word, WordStar, OpenOffice.org, Writer, all of these are open source. All of these are word processor. In word processor, we can create documents. So whenever we will use word processor, it means we can create document, we can format it, we can edit it. It means formatting means make your document more attractive, apply colorful font, italic font, number of different fonts are there, apply border, page borders. So many things are for formatting. What is the meaning of editing? Editing means making changes. For example, you want to delete something and you want to add something. It is called editing. In your syllabus, we will cover OpenOffice.org Writer. This software is a part of open source Office suite. So whenever you will install open source suite, there are different software automatically installed in your computer system. These are Writer, Base, then Impress, Calci. So these software automatically installed in your computer system. Look at here. In OpenOffice 4.1.7. This is the version of a software. In this, we have Base, Calci, Draw, Impress, Math, Writer. So all of these softwares are part of open source suite, and this software is easily available in internet. You can download and you can use it. Now my question is, what is open source? Students, raise your hands. Hurry up, beta, quickly give the answer. Archita, Dario,
sir, I don't know. Open
source. Gia,
sir, it's a term that people can use, I mean, edit and share.
So look at here. I'm giving first of all, what is open source? So look at here. I'm displaying the definition of open source in the screen. Open source software is a computer software that is released under a license in which the copyright holder grant user the right to use, study, change, and distribute the software and its source code to anyone and for any purpose. Now, the question is, there are so many latecomers. Now, question is, if I use MS Word, the Microsoft company provide us the .exe file. .exe files are machine level files. It means if I want to make any change in the software, it is not possible for me to make the changes. Look at here, I'm giving one demo. Look at here, I open the source code of look at here, your .exe file will look like this. Means non-readable format. It means we can run the program, but we can't edit. Aap usko change nahi kar sakte. अब हमारे पास जो ओपन सोर्स सॉफ्टवेयर्स हैं, इट्स कोडिंग इज अवेलेबल फ्री ऑफ कॉस्ट इन इंटरनेट. अगर मैं इंटरनेट में openoffice.org राइटर की कोडिंग इज ओपनली अवेलेबल, यू कैन डाउनलोड इट, यू कैन मेक द चेंजेस हियर एंड यू कैन इंट्रोड्यूस ए न्यू सॉफ्टवेयर विद डिफरेंट नेम. बट रिमेंबर वन थिंग, you will have to distribute this software. You can charge very nominal charges, but for business purpose, you can't use that software. For example, Mozilla Firefox, it is a very popular browser. And there is another software, Indian software, that is a advanced version of Mozilla Firefox. Coding is same. Coding is taken from Mozilla Firefox. So with the help of open source softwares, you can create, you can modify the coding and you can create your own software. But remember one thing, you must know the coding. Programming languages, you must have the knowledge of a programming language. So open source softwares jo hain, wo aapke paas paid bhi ho sakte hain, free of cost bhi ho sakte hain. Paid softwares with very nominal charges. But whenever it may be free of cost, for example, openoffice.org, Office, it is free of cost. Its coding is also available in the internet. Agar ye free of cost ho, isse hum kehte hain freeware. But agar iski coding bhi saath mein mil jaye, it is called open source. ठीक है, ये हमारे पास ओपन सोर्स में आपके पास सॉफ्टवेयर फ्री में ही है. आपके पास ओपन सोर्स में फ्री में हो भी सकता है, नहीं भी हो सकता. बट व्हेनेवर यू आर यूजिंग एनी सॉफ्टवेयर ओपन सोर्स, इट्स कोडिंग इज अवेलेबल इन फ्री ऑफ कॉस्ट. डेरिया, इज इट क्लियर?
यस सर.
ओके, नाउ द ओपन सोर्स ऑफ सॉफ्टवेयर्स, this person name is Richard Stallman. This person bring the idea of open source. So isne ek organization banayi thi jise hum kehte hain, look at here, this organization is called OSI, Open Source Initiative. This organization make the open source software popular. Otherwise, present time mein, all the softwares are, Maxim softwares are of Microsoft company and these are paid software and its coding is hidden from the user. And this person is very known IT personality, Richard Stallman. Now, next is when we open Writer, first of all, install openoffice.org office, download it from internet, and then install it. Whenever you will install, its window is just like MS Word. But remember one thing, MS Word is a proprietary software. Now, Gia, unmute yourself. What is proprietary software?
Yes, sir.
What is proprietary software?
Sir, I don't know.
Any student from 9th B? Charvi? Jaydev,
sir, I don't know.
Okay, madam. Dario.
Yes, sir.
What was my question? Yes, there. Give the answer, beta.
Sir, pro is.
Sir, may I give the answer?
Yes, sir. Yes, give the answer.
Sir, proprietary software is the software that is also known as non-free software. The software that does not respect users' freedom and community is called proprietary software.
Beta, the simple definition of proprietary software is the software for which we will have to pay the money, license money. For example, MS Word. If you want to use MS Word, you will have to buy the license, purchase the license to use the MS Word. So that's why MS Word is a proprietary software. So MS Word. Yes, Mr.
Sir, isn't OpenOffice a proprietary software?
No. I am saying MS Word is a proprietary software, but Writer is a open source.
Okay, sir.
Is it clear?
Yes.
Okay, madam. Now, just like other softwares, at the top, this is your title bar. These are different menus like file, edit, view, insert, table, tools, window, help. In these menus, there are different commands, different menu items. Now, one question for Pushti. Unmute yourself, Pushti.
Yeah.
Yes, beta. Unmute yourself, Raghav.
Yes, sir.
Pushti, if you see in a file, F is underlined. In edit, E is underlined. In insert, I is underlined. In format, O is underlined. In table, A is underlined. Why?
So your voice is not audible.
Beta, I'm saying in menu, in file, F is underlined. I think Karan, we want to give the answer. Yes, Beta. Give the answer. Karan?
We use it as a shortcut key.
Beta, these are for shortcut. if I press Alt key and F, look at here, file menu will appear. If I press Alt and press E, so look at here, edit will appear. If I press Alt I, insert menu will appear. If I press Alt O, format will be appear. If I press Alt A, table menu will appear. If I press Alt T, tools menu will appear. So these are the hotkeys. Okay, so these are used with the help of Alt key. So at after menu bar, these are called toolbar. In tools, commands are similar to the menu commands, but these are in the shape of small icons. For example, look at here, these are small icons. So every tool contains some commands. Suppose if I want to click on, if I want to create a new document, I will have to click on new tool. Okay, in the same way, there is an open tool, there is a save tool, there is a dot. Different tools are there. Different tools are grouped in different toolbars. For example, standard toolbar. In standard toolbar, the most commonly used tools are saved. In formatting toolbar, all the formatting tools are saved. In table toolbar, all the table tools are saved. In drawing toolbar, all the drawing tools are saved. So this is your standard toolbar. And after that, there is your formatting toolbar. This is your working area. Here we will have to type something just like MS Word. And these are ruler. These are horizontal. This is vertical. And at the bottom, there is drawing toolbar. And there is status toolbar at the end. For example, page 1 of 1. So status toolbar give the brief introduction about your document, how many pages you have used, your language, whether insert key is activated or not. So you can also slider. Here we can increase the view and decrease the view. So look at here. So these are the different component of writer window. So I am here typing different tools of writer window. Number one, title toolbar. So this is title bar. Then there is menu bar. There is toolbar. There is working area. There is status bar. There is ruler. These rulers may be horizontal or vertical. And these are scroll bar. Look at here. So with the help of scroll bar, we can move up or down or right or left. So look at here. These are scroll bar. So these are the different components of writer. So now next is in toolbar. In your book, there are different type of toolbars are standard toolbar, formatting toolbar, there is drawing toolbar. These are the common toolbar that is automatically available in the in your writer. It means these are preloaded. So other softwares like image toolbar, it will be appear when we insert the image. But these toolbar automatic preloaded automatically opened. So if you have any doubt, raise your hands. Arshita, any doubt in this? Arush? Yes, Arush, any doubt? Show your thumb impression if concept is okay. Now, next is in any word processor, there are some features. We are going to discuss these features. First feature of any word processor. Look at here. I am going to discuss features of word processor. So the first feature is fast. So just like other software, for example, if you open CorelDRAW, it is a very, very heavy software. But if we use Writer, it is a very lightweighted and fast software. Second feature is number two, editing. Editing features. Okay, students, formatting feature. Editing feature. So I have already discussed, if we want to make any changes in the document, this is called editing feature. Then there is formatting feature. So if you make your document more attractive, so this feature is called your formatting feature. Next is we can insert graphics in this. Next is OLE. This is called object linking and embedding. It means from Excel sheet, we can insert table. From PPT, we can insert slides. From other software, we can insert different component in our word processor. This is called OLE. Number six is spell checking. So spell checking, we can use, we can apply different spelling errors maybe there, and we, with the help of spell checking, we can find out that. Next is mail merge. So mail merge is a feature. By using that, we can combine two different files. One is Word file, another is database. So we will get multiple copies of same document. Next is permanent storage. So whatever we will save in word processor, the files will be saved, and these files will be for a long period. So these are the different features of word processor. Now next, whenever we will save the file in Writer, its extension is .odt. So note down, the extension of Writer file is .odt. So if you use MS Word, the extension is .docx. But whenever we are using Writer, so its extension will be .odt. So this is the extension of a Writer file. Next is, now we are going to continue with this topic. Next is when we want to create a new file, there are different methods. First method, click on file, click on new, and then click on text document. First method is click on file menu, click on new, and then click on text document. Automatically, a new document will be created. Second method, use shortcut key Control plus N. Then another way is, in your standard toolbar, there is one tool that is called new. If I click on that, a new document will be created. So look at here, by default, the writer file name will be untitled. It will be untitled 1, untitled 2, and untitled 3 like this. And whenever I click on file and click on save and give one name to the file, now the name of the file will be changed. So these may be the very small questions like extension of writerfile.odt. What will be the default name of writer file? This is untitled, untitled 1, untitled 2, like this. Next is, if we want to open already existing file, the way is click on file, click on open. Dialog box will appear, and then select the file which you want to open. Remember one thing, MS Word file can be opened in Writer, but Writer file can't be opened in MS Word. So this is the your feature of a Writer. So look at here, I open file. Look at here, MS Word file in here. Now next is, shortcut key to open the file is Control plus O. This is the shortcut key. Third method is, in standard toolbar, there is one tool that is called open. So if I click on open, here is a very small arrow is here. If I click on that, these files are recently opened files. In the same way, in a new tool, there is a arrow button, and then there are different type of files which we can create. We can create text file, we can create spreadsheet, we can create a presentation, we can create database like this. Now next is, if we want to close the file, you will have to click on file, click on close. So file, there will be one message by whether you want to save the file. If you want to save the file, click on save it. Discard means you don't want to save the file and you don't want to close the file. ठीक है, आपने फाइल को सेव नहीं करना, क्लोज भी नहीं करना. You will have to click on discard. And if you click on cancel, it means you don't want to close the file, you want to continue. So if I click on save, the file will be saved and you will have to give the name of the file. Now if I want to close the document, the OpenOffice.org writer, you will have to click on file, click on exit. Shortcut key is Control plus Q. Otherwise click on file and click on exit, or otherwise at the top of your title bar, there are three buttons: minimize, maximize, and close button. By using that, you can close the software. So next is, look at here, I type here, Look at here. Line is automatically changed when it reach the margin of your right margin of your document. What it called? This feature is called, yes, anybody? Daria.
Sir, text wrapping.
Beta, speak loudly.
Sir, text wrapping.
Yes, it is called text wrapping. Very good, beta. Very good. If you do in MS in Notepad, look at here. In Notepad, if I type something, look at here. We will have to apply this feature. Otherwise, line will not automatically change. We will have to click on format, click on word wrap. This is called word wrap. Okay. In Writer, your data is automatically shifted to the next line when we go to the right margin. This feature is called word wrapping. So remember one thing, word wrapping is an automatic feature of MS Word and also MS OpenOffice.org Writer. It means word processor mein ye inbuilt feature hai. Word processor mein. Okay. Okay, students. Time is over. Now I'm closing the meeting. Take care. Bye. And